Hey, and welcome back to Heimler's History. In these last few videos, we've been talking about how the Industrial Revolution began and how it spread. We've been saying that the Industrial Revolution was a massive change in world history, and no small part of that change was the technology that made it possible. And so in this video, we're going to be talking about technology in the Industrial Age. Let's get to it. And let me begin by telling you that there are, in fact, two industrial revolutions. And roughly, they're distinguished two ways. The first, they're distinguished by time periods. The first one happened first, and the second one happened second. And second, they're distinguished by the kind of technology that characterized each period. And I'm kind of in the mood to look at both. So the first industrial revolution took place roughly from the mid-18th century to the mid-19th century. And the major player in terms of technology in the first industrial revolution was the steam engine invented by our good buddy James Watt. So in a previous video, I mentioned that coal was the chief natural resource that got the industrial revolution going. In this video, I'm going to tell you why. So James Watt discovered that if you burn coal, then you could heat up water. And if you got that water hot enough, it would produce steam. And if you put that steam under pressure in an engine, that it could push a piston, which could then turn a wheel. That's probably like the worst explanation of the physics of the steam engine, but I mean, you get it, right? Coal, hot, steam, turn stuff. Now, why was that such a big deal? Well, do you remember what I told you in a previous video about the birth of the factory system? Well, if you don't, then let me tell you now. The factory system was born out of the power of the water frame. You stuck a wheel in the water turned it, and your factory made stuff. But think about that for a second. If your factory depends on running water, then that means that there's only so many places that you can actually build a factory. But now, if you got yourself a steam engine and a buttload of coal, then you could build a factory anywhere you wanted. It was a huge innovation that led to factories being built all over the place. But the steam engine didn't only revolutionize the factory, it also had a big effect on transportation as well. Example number one, ships. And as you may remember, up till this time, ships are powered by wind blowing into sails. But if you stick a steam engine on a ship, then it doesn't matter if the wind is blowing from this direction or that direction. You can go wherever you want because you don't need the wind anymore. And this had a big effect on trade. Rivers had long been used by merchants as one of the most efficient means to move goods to different places. But the problem is, rivers only flow in one direction, so you either had to row back upstream, which was very inefficient, or tow it back upstream from the shore. But pop a steam engine on a trade ship and now you can float that puppy downstream and then chug your way right back up. Easy peasy lemon squeezy. And so as a result of steamships, trade in all industrialized nations increased. Example number two, locomotives. Lay some railroad tracks, shove a steam engine in a locomotive, and that thing could pull crazy amounts of goods back and forth across a landmass. And again, this had some major effects. In Russia, the completion of the Trans-Siberian Railroad meant a flourishing trade with eastern states like China. And in the United States, the completion of the Transcontinental Railroad meant a big boom in trade across the country, and it facilitated significant migrations of people from the east to the west, and vice versa. Okay, so those are some of the greatest technological hits from the first industrial revolution. Now let's turn our attention and look to the second industrial revolution, which basically occurred from the mid-19th century to the early 20th century. Now the major players in the second industrial revolution were the United States, Great Britain, and Germany. So whereas the first industrial revolution majored in steam power, iron, and textiles, the second industrial revolution majored in steel, gas power, and communications. And now let's look at each of those in turn. First, steel. It was during this time that we see the rise of the mass production of steel, which was much stronger than iron. Steel became the building block of the Industrial Revolution because a new process for refining it was introduced. It was called the Bessemer process, and without getting into the technicalities of it, because let's be honest, I'm a history teacher, when we start talking about the physics of things, I'm at the very end of my mental capacities. The process was basically this. You blast hot iron with air, and that gets rid of all the impurities, and then you get steel. Anyway, the process of it doesn't matter. What matters is that the Bessemer process during this time gave people the ability to make mass quantities of steel. All right, now let's look at gas power, which was the byproduct of oil. And by the mid-1800s, oil wells were being drilled all over the dang place. Once the raw oil was in hand, then it could be refined and separated into kerosene and gasoline. Kerosene was used widely as a way to power lamps in people's homes, but it was gasoline that took over as the main benefit of oil extraction. The internal combustion engine was developed in the late 19th century, and it was similar to the steam engine in that it used pistons to turn cranks, but instead of being powered by steam, ignited gasoline pushed the pistons. Also in the second industrial revolution, there was a revolution in communications. And the reason why is because there were some major developments during this period in the harnessing of electricity. And one of the applications of this harnessed electricity was the telegraph. This little gadget was invented by Samuel Morse in 1837, and basically it was capable of sending pulses of electricity in a combination of long and short bursts along electrical wires at great distance. Building on this idea, in 1876, Alexander Graham Bell invented the telephone, which didn't just transmit bursts of electricity, but actual voices of actual human beings.
things.
Now let's stop there and mention a few of the major consequences of the advent of all of this new technology in both industrial revolutions. One major consequence was the increase of trade. With new means of transportation, first with the steam engine and then with the internal combustion engine, manufactured goods can now be shipped to distant markets far more efficiently. A second consequence of all of this is new waves of migration. Not only was it easier to travel to new parts of the globe, but once you got there, it was easier to communicate with your family members that you left back home. Because that was true, it was much easier to conceive of moving to places far off from your larger family, and that's going to have social consequences that we're going to explore more fully in the next unit. Okay, that's what you need to know about technology in the industrial age for AP World History Unit 5. If you're not already subscribed, then go ahead and join us and I'll keep making videos for you. You know, YouTube has been tracking your every move online, and they think based on all of your choices that you're going to love this video right here. And finally, if you want to help keep this channel viable and thriving, you could join the good folks at Patreon who donate monthly to this channel to help keep it afloat. Heimler out.